finds himself currently in sixth place from Germany. He was 11th in the world earlier this year, 10th in the Europeans, national champion of Germany four times. He's just out of that top 10. Michael Brezina, just one place above him in the top 10 of the worlds, and Florent Amodio just below him. That's the level of his quality. This is Peter Liebers of Germany. Quad toe, his opening scheduled element.
Just not quite managing to hold that landing. There wasn't really anything really majorly wrong with that. Double axel, managing to get that triple toe on the end. Very nice triple lutz. Just missing that triple axel. So triple lutz, double toe there. Salco, nicely done there. Coming towards the end of the program now. Triple loop. Everything's just kind of all right, you know?
Some very strong elements in there, in particular the Lutz. There were five triples well done. So close on the quad, so close on the triple axel. But he gave it all he could, and there's a lot to admire there from Peter Liebers of Germany. Seems like one of those things that he does very big jumps and it takes a while to set them. And if they came off, they'd have this impact. Do you think?
Yeah, I guess if they came off, you know, they would have impact. But for me, that was... I found that boring as a whole. I didn't find it entertaining. I found it awkward in places for him. You know, he didn't look relaxed. It doesn't look like a natural... flow on the ice. I don't know. I just didn't enjoy that too much, I have to say.
And it's not easy to say that, is it? Because you don't want to say that.
No. I mean, everybody goes out there to do their best, and you know, we all have personal preferences or favorites, or you know. But for me, it just was, having watched two great skaters before, I didn't enjoy. I don't know. Just. Yeah, great. Some of the technical elements, really good. But it just didn't flow for me. It didn't gel.
More of a traditional style in some ways of, for me, how male figure skating was, going from element to element, not... And when it works, that can hold the crowd and hold my interest. But when it doesn't quite, it loses it. He was 20 years old when he did his first Worlds, was 32nd there. So he's moved himself up incrementally. 25 he was for the next 2 years, then 15th, and down to 20th, and up to 11th this year, his highest position. And at the moment, in order to get above Richard Dornbusch, he'd almost need to get his best score that he got at the Worlds this year. 2.16 is his best ever score. Richard got 2.15. And he's going to have to really go some on this. I think it's going to be quite difficult for him to achieve that on that performance. But anything's possible. And sometimes I feel that the overall judging is going up. Where's it going to be? Second. 1.97 just slots in between Richard Dornbusch and Misha G. Two deductions for the falls. Not bad marks on the presentation. Those elements would have made all the difference.